Welcome back, I'm John Furrier, host of theCUBE here in theCUBE's NYSE studio on the East Coast. Of course, we have our Palo Alto studio in Silicon Valley, connecting Wall Street and Silicon Valley tech and capital. Jamie Domenici is here, CMO of Klaviyo. Jamie, welcome to theCUBE.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming over from the NRF show.
Thank you for having me. It's great to be here.
You guys are doing extremely well, went public here on the NYSE. You're in the middle of the retail situation. As you look at the operational benefits that is coming with AI, the customers and then the end users of retail, they're seeing a significant benefit. What's the vibe at NRF this year? I heard the numbers were huge.
Yeah, it's great. This is my fifth, sixth. I've been there a few times, and I would say the vibe is different this year. I feel like, you know, retail's being disrupted. AI is a disruptor. Customer experience, redefining it, that's the playing field. What's different this year, retailers are showing up and they're ready. Like, this is not the future, the time is now, and they're going on the floor really proactively figuring out, how do I leverage AI? How do I take it to the next level? It's real, it became real.
I mean, AI has always been one of those things where it's a strategy, it's not strategy risk at this point. I mean, everyone I talk to from the boardroom to the management layer, we need to infuse AI in our business. Okay,
yeah.
That's kind of become the cliche and the talking point. But then now the shifts to execution risk.
Yeah.
So to me, the vibe is, okay, strategy, directionally, we know what to do.
Yes.
Tactically, what do we do?
That's the problem. So it's almost like vision, it was a cost center, like you have to do it, spend the money, I don't know why. And now retailers are saying, I'm ready, but help me figure it out. So I think people like Klaviyo, who I'm with, we were built for this, we're ready. We're like, we've already thought about it for you, we're going to tell you the steps, help you build the data, help you get the personalization. So it's been fun, it's been a great show.
And the retail market too has always been kind of like, I won't say slow mover, but they're smart movers, the money.
Yeah.
They listen to the consumer. The consumer speaks with their wallet.
Yeah.
And when they see impact, they move. So what's your takeaway on that? What's the big awakening, or what's the big aha moment in retail as of right now?
Well, I would say you hit it. Consumers are driving the change. And coming off of BFCM, we already saw a shift. 85% of consumers that we surveyed said, I'm going to take an AI recommendation, and I'm going to buy because of that. So the consumers are ahead, and now retailers are having to adapt. And they really, it comes down to personalization, right?
Yeah.
You need to know that buyer, you need to understand their preferences, and you need to be relevant in the moment that they're shopping. And agents and AI and data are critical to do that.
I wrote a story before NRF, and a lot of the feedback I got was, it's beyond chatbots, recommendation engines, and demand forecasts. That's the classic analytics, retail's been all over that. It's now an operating system, and it's the central nervous system of retail operations.
Yes.
Take us through how you guys see that. What's your vision for your company?
Yep.
How are you guys meeting them at that point?
Yeah.
Because it's not a reset or a pivot.
Yeah,
it's a trajectory change.
No, this is where we were built. So it's so funny you said central nervous system, because that's how I explain Klaviyo. Companies like Mattel, Glossier, Away Luggage, if you use Away, they use Klaviyo as their central nervous system. So we're kind of the backbone of the business, collecting every single customer interaction, whether you bought in store, you're on their site, maybe you're buying in ChatGPT. We bring all that information into one place and then allow you to take action quickly, whether it's email, SMS, pop-ups, promos. Wherever we are today or wherever we're going, we help you build that infrastructure so that you're ready, right? You're communicating and you're really personalized in the moment.
It's interesting. I didn't even contact you for my post, but I want to quote what I wrote on Sunday. Before AI shapes the consumer experience, it is fixing the internal plumbing. This is not glamorous work, but it's foundational. The retailers who get this right build velocity, they move faster, onboard quicker, scale and expertise across the organization. AI becomes the nervous system of the enterprise, colon, the operating system.
Yes.
That sounds like what you just said.
Honestly, you're speaking my language.
Okay, so explain how you guys deploy. Take us through a day in the life of a customer. Okay, I want to lean in. What do I do? Do I have to kind of deploy multiple systems? Take us through the use case.
So that's another trend that I'm seeing is your sort of unified commerce system. Like you need a vertically integrated tech stack. So let me just take you through it.
Yeah.
No, you don't need multiple systems. It's not multiple days. It's not multiple weeks. It's not a year-long implementation. You got to move faster than that. But it starts with data. So Klaviyo actually started 15 years ago. We started as a database. And it's a composable database. So again, you're like, okay, Jamie. But basically, we allow you to connect with any interaction you have with your customer and build a lifetime profile. So anything you've ever done when shopping, go to a website, go in store, you browsed, you bought, we keep everything, size, color, preference. You know, I like to shop at night. That's when I have time. I like looking at text. So I keep all of that information and store it in a database. And on top of that, we have marketing, we have service. You know, okay, these things have been around forever, yeah. But Klaviyo, we're really using AI to modernize it for you. So our marketing agent, press a button, and we're going to say, you know what, based on all the data we have, it looks like this set of customers is ready to repurchase. They bought, you know, a top, here's the pants. Send them an email. Press a button, we'll create it for you. But marketing alone is not enough. Customer experience and marketing have to blend, especially when you have an agent. So Klaviyo, we also have our customer agent, which is taking all that insight, helping you build marketing, set recommendations, and answer support questions all in one.
Well, first of all, AI is hot, and the traders are going crazy behind us.
I know. I'm like, do you do this all day, every day?
I love it here.
Yeah.
The Friday was hot, too. You can see the market down, up and down. It's good colors on the board.
Yeah. All the energy.
Exactly. And I think this operating system concept is interesting. I want to get your thoughts on this because it's interesting. You guys came at it from a data perspective.
Yes.
And it wasn't like a top-down, you got on a whiteboard and said, here, customer, let's do a solution map.
No.
You guys came at it from a very unique, narrow entry database.
Yes.
But it was flexible enough to adapt to the world.
Easy, yes, our founders, Harvard grad school, they made an incredible database that was a composable database. So it's easy for a marketer. You don't have to build a spreadsheet, format all the data, upload SQL, like those days are over.
Yeah.
As a marketer myself, I just need you to get the data, get it in and match it for me.
Yeah.
And make it easy, and that's where we started.
Okay, so Jamie, I have to get your thoughts on this because I love this bottoms up kind of a think differently. And the world spins in the direction when you get the vision right, which is great for you guys. But that's bucking against conventional wisdom. So if you go look at that time, the state of the art SaaS MarTech stack was that graph of all these different logos. I mean, the MarTech stack was good for Web 2.0, but really didn't address some of these generative use cases. Like, oh, a customer's ready to buy, generate some content.
Oh, yes.
This is what you're talking about.
Yeah, we are.
What's the MarTech stack look like? I guess it's not a stack, it's more of what happened to the MarTech stack that we knew from say 5 to 8 years ago to today? How would you describe that change?
I mean, I think it looks really different today. I think it's going to look really different tomorrow. Much like we have sort of last week at CES, we're talking about the autonomous car. Last night I was talking with a grocer about autonomous supermarkets.
Yeah.
Right, so you walk in and people already know who you are. And I equate that to the autonomous CRM. So now your tech stack, I mean, I don't want to date myself, but my first marketing automation was in Excel, so I'm going way back.
Oh my God, macros.
Yes, I know, like strangely excited about it, but it's so different now. You know, marketers are really, they're more like engineers, and the tech is doing the work for them, but they're the data engineers. They're the human in the loop, and technology is actually using the data layer and taking action and making prescriptive recommendations, and the marketer's acting on it. Right, saying yes, no, listening to customer insights, building out personalized campaigns, flows, and now I would say marketing and customer success are overlapping a lot more.
It's interesting, I mean, much as retail, I mean, retail deserves a lot of credit for understanding data. They've been very good at insights.
Yes.
On the action side, take us through where insights and actions convert, because you're kind of coming at it from, okay, you got all this data, we can connect to it, with the nervous system, with you guys, but now action is point of sale, which is either digital or physical.
Well, everything's a checkout now, right?
Yeah.
So that doesn't matter if you're in a store or if you're in ChatGPT, and who knows what's going to happen tomorrow? You wake up and something's new. So I think the really companies that are going to succeed, they're thinking about that, and they're creating a tech stack, bringing all of their information into one, and they need to take action immediately. You cannot wait.
Yeah.
You do not have 3 days for someone to build you a flow or a campaign and a marketing email, SMS. You don't have time for that.
Yeah.
So at Klaviyo, we're bringing that all into one place. The data layer, email, SMS, analytics, and action. So you can immediately get your flows and campaigns down to the personalization level within minutes, within seconds.
So velocity, on the velocity piece, you got, remember the omni-channel, now you have unlimited channels. You have generative things that are going to come in, prompts. So you got to be ready for that unified layer.
Yes.
How do you market that? And take us through some of the conversations you've had at NRF, in the hallways, in meetings. What's resonating? What's the positioning? How do you explain the value? And how do customers create the value and extract the value?
Well, you're talking my language. I love marketing. I'm talking about, and I'm market to marketer, so my job is really
You got to be good. High bar.
They can sniff you out. So that's where we talk about CRM built specifically for B2C companies. Klaviyo did this, where we're actually helping you automate everything. So this B2C CRM, talking about autonomous marketing. But really what they like is we make it real. So I could just show you our marketing agent, and our customers are like, oh, I need that. Or let me give you an example. We have something called Customer Hub. So Third Love, they sell intimate apparel. They need to know you. When you come on, like, what have you bought before? And they don't want to search. Their customers don't want to look. They want you to come to their website and know them. So with our Customer Hub, we create a personalized experience. We know everything you've bought. We can tell you recommendations. And we can answer support questions all in one. And Third Love doesn't need to have somebody who's managing it. With Klaviyo, it's always on all the time and personalized to every buyer.
And how's that working for some of the customers? They love it?
It's great. Results? I mean, I think they found like 200% growth in 5 days just from turning this on. Because customers don't want to be targeted.
Yeah.
They don't want to get an email when no one knows them anymore. They want a full end-to-end experience that starts and ends in every single interaction they have with your brand.
As you guys had your growth strategy and continue to grow, one trend that's coming out of this year's Trailblazers with retail and NRF is the folks that were leaning in and scratching the surface with agents a year ago have extended that out and were kind of prepped for the agent hype that's going on now.
Yeah.
And they've seen explosive record growth,
record
revenue. What have you guys learned? What's been the learnings of the past year? And what's the focus for next year?
Great question. I mean, you can't walk down NRF without seeing agent. Yeah. Everything is an agent. Build an agent.
Yeah.
So I think we launched two agents last year. One for the back of house, which is your marketing agent, makes your job easier. One front of your house, which is customer agent. And what we've learned, that customer agent has to be smart, it has to be trained, it has to have the right information, and it really has to be personal. So where we know where the world is going, it's no longer just build a great product, have a great marketing campaign, know your buyer, but also more and more brands are having to build an experience. So I don't just buy a pair of running shoes. When I go online, I want to say, where are you going to be going? Here's the outfit you should wear. Here's the temperature. Here's a training plan. So more and more companies are thinking about building an experience, not just a point of sale product.
What's the profile of your customer base right now? How would you classify your current business mix?
Honestly, we're from entrepreneur to enterprises. And
you're pretty horizontal.
Yeah.
Any retail operations, physical stores with digital or digital, 100% digital
across
too.
The board. You have a store, you have an end customer, you're doing B2C, like we can help you.
Does the word CRM scare people?
I love CRM, so you're talking to the wrong gal. And you know what, our customers have, that's what they, how they identify. Yeah. They run CRM. Yeah. They run their customer
CRMs.
Management. Yeah, so I would say it's not scary, but it is changing and modernizing. So the CRM of yesteryear is not the CRM of the future.
Do people get enamored by the fact that a CRM could be flexible and responsive, customizable? Because some people I talk to have a view of, I love my CRM because it's my system of records, all the truth. And then on one hand, on the other hand, it's like, it's too slow, it's antiquated, it's the 90s software, big company rollout, I got a call for a ticket support.
Yeah.
So there's kind of like the old school. So take me through that bridge, because I think, you know, CRM as a concept is customer relationship management.
Yeah.
I mean, conceptually, it's categorically relevant.
Yeah.
But talk about how it's modernized.
It's a great question. And I think we have customer relationship management. In my world, it's kind of consumer relationship management, because you have to go down to that individual consumer in the retail space. Where I think it's going is autonomous. I do, which also used to be a scary word, because then you're like, what's my job? How do I play? Where are we going? I mean, this is a reality. We're moving to an autonomous world where every marketer, every customer support agent, every company should press a button, get insights and take action. But I think it's getting less scary. I keep falling off my chair here. I think it's getting less scary because people are understanding where the human in loop fits. right? Yeah. And they're understanding, I still need to have oversight. I own the brand, I'm the CMO, I'm still gonna do great creative, but I need this technology to help make my job easier, and I think people appreciate it.
I think people see value. This is a year of value for what we're reporting. I think the abstraction away of complexity is a tailwind for retail.
Yeah.
Because the scary part has been, I want to get something done, but I got to jump through hoops, or I got to integrate this.
Yes.
You mentioned you don't need multiple systems. I can just do data connectors. You can put an abstraction layer on top of with software.
Yes, unified commerce system.
Yeah.
That vertically integrated stack. It's not as sexy as you want, but it's actually critical, and it's becoming a differentiator. One of the things I was surprised too when I entered into the B2C space, into this retail world, everything was so fragmented. People will run email over here, text over here, their website over here. And as a CMO myself, I'm like, why are you doing that?
Yeah.
So omnichannel, I know, is something we take for granted and it seems commonplace, but it's actually not. It's something that now, I would say, is now just becoming a bit more mainstream and adopted.
Yeah.
Send me a text at night, an email during the day. You know,
I mean, we were researching with some customers that were saying that, hey, we have this fragile IT system, multiple systems, but they're just running agents under the covers to do the back and forth to unify it.
Yes.
Either data connectors through APIs or delegated agents that are trusted across. And it's completely transparent to the customer.
Which I think is okay.
And that's okay.
I think that's
okay. Good.
I think that's what
I don't want
consumers want, right? We want instant gratification. We want answered. We want our questions answered. But we also want, the consumer wants you to know who they are. Which I just think that understanding versus targeting, I just think we're finally there. We've been talking about it a long time, but it's really becoming real.
All right, talk about, put a plug in for the company, what your priorities are, what you guys' value proposition is, what's your priorities?
Yeah, that's a great question. Thank you for asking. Yeah. But at Klaviyo, we're a CRM built specifically for B2C companies. And as I said, you said, I love it. Quote me, I'll quote you.
All right.
We're like your central nervous system. So companies, Mattel, Glossier, Away Luggage, I've been with them all week on the floor. They're using us to really bring all their information into one place and take action on it immediately.
So. And what's the results they're seeing? Can you share some of the KPIs?
Yeah, I mean, what we're seeing is, we call it KAV, which is your Klaviyo Attributed Value. And customers are seeing leaps and bounds coming, you know, directly from their agent sales and thinking about how they can drive efficiency across the board. So better connections, better relationships, which is creating long-term revenue.
Yeah, and that's another point people don't miss. They think AI is a cost reducer. It's a revenue driver.
Revenue driver.
When you do it right.
When you do it right.
Well, Jimmy, thanks for coming on theCUBE. Appreciate it. You guys are blazing the trail. Next year, what are your top goals?
Top goal, all AI, right? Yep. So continuing to build that autonomous marketing and autonomous service. And I think where Klaviyo is going to be leading the charge is how we bring that together into one unified customer experience that blends the best of both worlds and making that growth.
And you're expanding globally too?
We're going around the world. Yeah, we've been expanding already for the last 3 years, but we're expanding out in Europe, and then we just opened an office in Singapore, so we're really going into new offices and new frontiers.
All right, well, thanks for coming on theCUBE, appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
All right, you're watching the Retail Trailblazers. I'm John Furrier, host of theCUBE, where they're changing the game, where AI is changing the customer experience, business operations, and ongoing change in AI with user benefit.